Hi, on this episode of DevOps Lab, Zach is going to walk us through how to create deployment groups so we can deploy our apps behind firewalls.
Let's take a look.
Hi. Welcome to the DevOps Lab. On this episode, again, we are joined by a very special guest, Zach. How are you doing, Zach?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Doing awesome. So, in our last episode, you showed us how to create a build pipeline for my .NET application, right?
Yeah.
So this time around, this is when the fun starts, because now we need to deploy that app behind my firewall into some of my on-prem servers, right?
Yeah, so we've taken your application and we've created an artifact mm-hmm. that we're going to use on these servers to deploy. Mm-hmm. So to do that, because you're behind a firewall, we're going to have to create a deployment group.
Okay.
We're going to have to add that server into the deployment group. I'm sorry, the servers you're going to deploy to into the deployment group.
Okay, that sounds pretty scary to me. Like, you're not going to touch any firewall settings or anything at all, and it's just going to magically work?
Yeah, as long as your server can reach the internet and can communicate with Azure DevOps, we don't have to poke any holes in your firewall.
Wow, all right, show me this.
All right, let's take a look at it.
Okay.
So what we see here is we just finished the build. The artifact is here. We just looked at the drop. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go to deployment groups.
Okay.
And I already have some here for testing, but let's go ahead and create a new one.
All right.
Let's call this test. So this is my test deployment group. All right, so we've created that.
Okay.
And now this is really cool. So we've created the deployment group, and to make it even easier, mm-hmm. it gives you the code that you need to run on your server. You can do it for a Windows server, you can do it for a Linux server, but this is literally the code I need to run. And even better, mm-hmm. I can click this button and it adds the authentication for me. I don't have to do anything.
Oh, wow.
So okay. I've got my code here. I'm going to copy it to my clipboard.
All right.
I'm already logged into my server and I'm going to paste that code and run it.
Oh, wait a minute. So you just, what just happened? You just logged into your server, right? So this is your server sitting behind your firewall. And you pulled up a PowerShell window, pasted the script, and now what is it doing?
Yeah, so right now what it's doing is it's pulling down the code that's needed and it's registering this agent with that deployment group.
Pretty cool. So it's hitting Azure DevOps, pulling down the agent code, installing an agent, configuring it so it's going to be inside of that deployment group. And it
exactly.
does all of that for you?
Yes, it does all that. And it does ask if we want to tag it.
Mm-hmm.
And I will tag this
okay.
Because it is a database server. So I'll tag it with DB.
Okay.
And now we've got a tag as well, which is really interesting. You can use tags inside of deployment groups
okay.
to deploy to specific assets inside of that deployment group. So say you have a dev deployment group.
Yeah.
You could have web servers tagged web, DB mm-hmm. servers tagged DB. And if you only want to deploy to the web servers, use that dev deployment group with a web tag, and you're only hitting the web servers with your deployments.
Cool. So you can have multiple machines in a deployment group?
Yeah, definitely.
So if I have, a database, right, server, maybe like three nodes for my web server, they would all go into this deployment group?
They can. You can do it really however you want to. You could have a web deployment group with only web servers,
mm-hmm.
Or you could have an entire environment mm-hmm. Deployment group where you set tags that match whatever kind of server you're deploying to.
Okay. So then when I'm deploying, I can just deploy to a certain tag?
Yeah, exactly.
So let's say I have three nodes,
mm-hmm.
and I say deploy to this particular group using this particular tag,
yeah.
with my web tag, it'll just fan it out and deploy it to all three of those?
Yeah, as long as they have that web tag inside of that deployment group, it's going to hit only those servers.
Very cool. Yeah. So if behind my load balancer I have like 100 machines, this becomes a really easy way to deploy to all 100 machines?
Yeah, and you get to segment that however you'd like, whatever works best for your company or your purpose.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, so what's next?
And I just noticed it's also going to ask for the account to use for the service. And
mm-hmm.
so in this case, I'm going to use my test admin mm-hmm. account, which is my administrator account for this, and the password for that account.
Okay.
So let me get that typed in. And I gave the wrong password. There we go. So we're all good.
Fantastic. Wait, we're done?
We're done. So
that's all we need to do?
Yeah, if we go back to the portal here,
uh-huh.
We can see that we have a new target. That's my my demo WinDB target inside of this deployment group.
Very cool. So let me just recap to make sure I understand. If we want to deploy behind a firewall, What we need to do is we need to create something called a deployment group.
Yes.
Right. And once we have this deployment group, we can then install agents on all the machines that we want to deploy to.
Exactly.
And then these agents, the way they communicate is they will reach out into the internet to Azure DevOps Services, does whatever they need to, and then they will deploy on whatever machine they're installed on.
Exactly. It's kind of like a client-server relationship. They're actually doing the request, and the server saying, here's what you need to run.
Great. And so if I deploy one of these agents on every single machine that I want to deploy to, for instance, I have 100 nodes behind a load balancer, I would then just say, deploy to this particular deployment group with the tag of web, and then it'll just deploy to all of them.
Exactly. You could have your web, app, DB, as many different types of services you want in that deployment group.
Man, that's fantastic. That's super easy. So then what's our next step? Is just create a pipeline?
Yeah, the next step is to create a release pipeline and actually get the build that we created earlier pushed out.
Awesome. I cannot wait to see this. And that is what we are going to do next time.